Hey there, everybody. I know I'm coming live a little early today. I'm actually out running errands and I'm probably not going to be able to get on tonight. But anyway, I heard something today that made me stop and want to have a conversation with you all. Hi, my name is Chrissy Blevio. I'm a busy mom and an entrepreneur. I live here on the Gulf Coast of Florida and it is 84 degrees. And I'm only letting you know because somebody always asks. It's a kind of cloudy, partly cloudy, sunny, breezy 84 degrees today. Anyway, I was listening to, actually it was a video of a guy, an online social media business type guru named Gary Vaynerchuk. I might be saying that a little wrong. And Lord, don't ask me how to spell that. I'm trying to see who's here. I can't see. Hi. Don't know how to pronounce your name, Mayor. Anyway, Gary Vaynerchuk. And I'll tell you what he was talking about. He's not everybody's cup of tea. He really loves the F word. I don't know if that's trying to appeal to a younger audience. And I don't know what that says about our younger people. But yeah, a lot of F-bombs. And listen, I'm no nun. If you know me from school, when I was a kid or, you know, my 20s, you know I'm no nun. But it's a little much. Anyway, he was speaking to an audience of mostly younger people. Hey, Jana, how are you? And there was this young man in the audience. Oh my gosh. And I could hear everybody's eyes roll, right? He lives in Texas and he starts saying, well, you know, I want to go into the weed business. Okay. He wants to sell marijuana. That's his dream. Whatever, you know, whatever whatever you think about that issue, you know, it was a business conversation. So his thing was, well, I mean, that's what I really want to do. And, but you know, the laws are such in Texas that I can't do it. And they can do it in Denver, Colorado. But we can't do it here. And the guy's like, so Gary's like, yeah. So effing move. So the kid starts kind of moaning about, well, why should I have to move? And you know, the laws and da-da-da-da-da. And Gary Vaynerchuk says, listen, nobody gives a F about your feelings. He said, I'm sorry, that might be harsh. But, you know, you've got all these reasons. You know, you got this dream. You tell us what your dream is, your dream job or your dream business. And then you got all these reasons why you can't do it. And how it's not fair. And he said, nobody gives an F about your feelings. Move. He said, you know, what is that? So he got a little harsh with the guy, you know, kind of really laid into him a bit. But then at the end, he said, listen, what, you know, your problem is not so much those excuses. It's the poison behind that. He said, man, you've got some poison to deal with. There's some poison behind all those excuses. You know, the excuses are kind of like the symptom on the surface, but that means, you know, you got some poison behind that. You need to figure out what that poison is. And so now I tell this story and, you know, it's a young kid who wants to go in the weed business. I know a lot of y'all are saying out there, well, oh, you know, these young people, probably one of those kids who needs a safe space or ponies and cotton candy, you know, can't disappoint them. He probably feels entitled, like we should roll out the red carpet and change all the laws because he has this dream. And you know, that's not reality. You know what really got Gary Vaynerchuk pissed was when this kid started talking about rich people. And he said, oh, don't even go there. Don't even go there. The vast majority of people in America, this might be news to some people out there, made their own freaking money. They made their own way. I mean, I have actually had friends of mine shock me by complaining about people born, you know, all these wealthy people in America born with a silver spoon in their mouth. I believe it is at least 80%, maybe higher, of the millionaires and very, you know, wealthy, successful people in America, they did that on their own. They did not inherit that. Nobody handed it to them. Okay, so, you know, Gary Vaynerchuk's thing, it was tough love, but so anyway, you know, yes, young people, you know, a lot of them do feel entitled. I don't want to paint all young people like that. We see a lot of that in the news. We have some fantastic young people in this country who will grow up and be entrepreneurs, who will blaze a path, who will invent, you know, wonderful things and open great companies. But we do have an issue with these kind of self-entitled. But we kind of think of kids when we think of that, you know, the excuses and the maybe the little bit of pissing and moaning, I don't know. But I have to say, there are a lot of adults out there who do the same thing. There are a lot of adults I hear come across who say, well, you know, I do have this dream. I do have this dream of this life I want, or this life I want to create, or I've always dreamed of running my own business, or, you know, whatever the dream is. I mean, let's face it, you know, a lot of dreams have price tags. You need the money to make the dream happen. Oop, I don't know what happened to my light just then. Uh-oh, that's my view. No, I'm not at the burger joint. It's across the street. But I can't eat meat on my diet. Anyway, but I find a lot of adults do the same thing. And I guess my harsh question is, you know, these excuses where I don't have the time, or I'm too busy. You know, it's not the right time, or, you know, I got a lot going on right now, or, you know, we're going to be moving. So whatever the excuse is, you know, that's fine. You want to make excuses for not even attempting your dream. I mean, nobody can guarantee you that you'll reach your dream. But my question is, you know, when you're old and in a wheelchair, or, you know, your last breath, or, you know, your last days, and you think back on your life and how you didn't even try. It's one thing to try and fail, but man, when you don't even try, I'm sorry. Is that going to be your legacy? Do you really want that when you're older, to think back that, you know, you didn't even try, that you had these lame excuses? You know, business is tough. Success is tough. And, you know, if it wasn't, everybody would be successful, right? I mean, we'd all have a ton of money and we'd all be living the dream. But it's only those people that are going to make it a priority. And, you know, you're too busy. I'm sure something you're doing could be put on the back burner while you're putting a few hours, you know, 2-3 hours a day into whatever your dream is, whatever that pursuit is. Anyway, it was really entertaining to watch him. Like I said, he's not everybody's cup of tea. The cursing. I mean, it was really excessive. I don't know, but at the same time, he really makes a point, and he makes it. Yeah, he doesn't sugarcoat it. You know, nobody gives an F about your feelings, and you can cry, you can make excuses, but at the end of the day, that's all you got of those excuses. You're going to let those excuses keep you from going after your dream. And at least you could say, I went after it. Okay, I didn't reach it, but I went after it. But somebody who doesn't even try, who's just got an excuse every day, I'm just, you know, my question is, is that excuse going to make you feel better when you're 90 years old and you look back and, I'm not saying you're having a horrible life, but when you look back and you think about that dream you had that you never even went after, or, you know, things that you would have liked to have done if you could have increased your income and you didn't do it. So anyway, that's my question. That's my little chat here. I'm trying to see. Janice says the next generation is too entitled, but yes, many have excuses. Hi, Tracy. Yeah, I mean, you know, but I don't know that almost, yes, many of the young people do. Many of them are absolutely outrageous. I don't know where this idea of that success is easy to come by. I guess maybe some people like to think that the successful people they see had some kind of advantage they didn't have. You know, everybody's got an advantage or a disadvantage. I don't care what color you are. I don't care how fat you are, how skinny you are, how old you are, how young you are. We all have things about us that can hold us back, and other things that can propel us. That you can let them be an excuse, or you can go out there and fight like hell to succeed and achieve your dreams. So anyway, I really love that video. I actually stayed up a little too late last night watching a lot of his videos, not for prime time, that's for sure. But I just wanted to tell you about that. That really had an impression on me. When he told that kid, you know, nobody cares about your feelings. And what, so the bottom line is, if you are a person who makes excuses, if you know somebody who does that, share this video with them, tag them in it. It's not so much the excuses, but what's behind that? Where are those excuses coming from? What inside you, is making excuses for yourself? What is the benefit, or, you know, what's behind that? I don't know the answer to that. I just know it's a damn good question and you have to figure it out. It's an individual thing. Anyway, I'm out running errands. I'm hoping to maybe get my hair trimmed. I don't know. I got grocery shopping to do. And all that good stuff that never ends, right? Any mom out there knows that stuff never ends. Anyway, I want to thank you so much for watching my broadcast today. I know the lighting's not so hot. I did not expect to get on, but I realized I've got appointments. And when I heard that video, I've just been thinking about it. I just wanted to share it with you. So anyway, you all have a fantastic, what is it, Tuesday evening, and I will check in with you tomorrow. Bye-bye.